out your smart mouth, drawing me in and you kicking me out. You've got my head spinning, no kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride, and I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright. My head's underwater.
Who's always taught to be grateful for what you have? Who's taught to settle for the nice car, clean clothes, and food on the table? Who was also taught that money don't bring happiness? But is this enough to make me happy? We was taught that if you can't do the time, don't do the crime. And we was taught that these streets ain't safe without a gun. We also was taught that if you about to do a life sentence, you better off spending life in jail than snitching on somebody and dying out here in these streets. It's crazy, because that person that's telling you not to snitch will snitch on you in a second. But am I supposed to be happy? Fact is that no matter how famous you is, like Shaq is, he need Nike or he need Adidas to start his own sneaker line or clothing line. Because to people where I'm from, Shaq's is corny. The fact is that it's black people that's killing another black person because that black person was waiting in line since 6 o'clock in the morning or 3 o'clock in the morning to get some Jordans that he couldn't even get. The fact is, the person whose pocket we put $200 in, it's not Michael Jordan, it's the person who owns Nike. But is this enough to make Mike or Shaq happy? I see that if you wear something one time and you put it on IG, it don't matter if you went out or not. If you put it on Instagram or Facebook, you can't wear that again. And I see people that's getting $300 checks every 2 weeks of hard work, and they spend that $300 on a Gucci belt instead of paying $100 to start their own business. Am I supposed to be happy? I also see grown people that have so much spare time on their hands, but still don't know what they want to do with their life, or still don't know how they're going to feed their family. I see friends and family that need someone to lead them by example. When we get to the ninth grade, we supposed to know what we want to do for a career. But I see people that's trying to lead by words and not by actions. I see people that don't even have a purpose on this earth. But am I supposed to be happy? All this time, you're looking for a significant other. You're missing out on making yourself significant. That's why it's called a significant other. If you're significant, whether you like it or not, you're going to find that person that's significant. But if you're not significant, you will never find that significant other. And it will never work out for you. Everybody wants to be Jay-Z. Everybody wants to be Will Smith. But sit and ask yourself, are you doing everything that Jay-Z and everything that Will Smith did to be successful? We so quick to say I can't, and so quick to make excuses of our situation because we're in a bad situation. When everything around you is turning bad, some type of way, it's so easy to settle and so easy to make that bad normal. You can do anything you put your mind to. Let me say that again. You can do anything that you put your mind to. Only time you really can't execute something is when you tell yourself you can't, or when you really can't breathe. Never say I can't. Never. Most remembered people and wealthy people had to almost die to be successful. Or they had to literally die so their family and friends can live and live comfortable forever. The people where I'm from are so closed-minded and hate constructive criticism. If you want to be a person like Martin Lawrence, whose show we love, whose show it might be on right now as I'm talking, you have to be 20 different people in one person like Martin did. Martin wasn't just Martin in his show. He was Shanae Jenkins. He was Roscoe. He was Jerome, King B, Bob, Mama Payne, Elroy, and more. When I think of Shanae or Roscoe, or any of the characters Martin act like, I didn't think of Martin. I think of those characters. So for Martin to be the best Martin possible, he had to be 20 different people in one body. So if you want to be remembered or you want to be wealthy, you have to have 20 different hustles. Don't never settle for one hustle, because that one hustle will let you down. Now you got 19 hustles to fall back on. We have to be open-minded. and stop worrying about what the next person is doing or how the next person feel about the actions we do. Because that thought or you holding back will stop you from making actions in the first place. You have to be open-minded and perceive things the right way. I could be having the same conversation with my family as I'm having with somebody in my hood or somebody, a stranger that I don't know. But for the simple fact that we perceive things different, we will get something out of three different things or five different things out of this one conversation. But what we don't understand, if we perceive things the right way, just by perceiving something the right way, you can get what you want out of life. Just because you're perceiving something the right way, you don't have to make a mistake if you're perceiving something the right way. But if you're not perceiving something the right way, you're going to have to make that mistake and learn from it. But if you perceive things the right way, you can make, you won't have to make that mistake, because you already perceived what's going to happen if you do. If you're that person that's stuck in your ways, when you watch TV or when you're reading something, you would never fully understand what you read or what you saw. If Martin would have cared about what people thought about him dressing up as a girl, he wouldn't be remembered 20 years after he did his show. He only is remembered because he did what people wouldn't do. He was creative. He didn't care what people thought about him. The key to life is finding your genius level talent and executing every step that you have to execute to reach your goal. Don't ever let somebody tell you you can't do it. Don't ever let somebody distract you, because that's what they want to do. Don't give them what they want.